Hey, it's Mikey. Let's talk Black Ops 3 and Easy Sniper Bloodthirsties, aka how to unlock Chameleon on the snipers. I get this question every couple days, so I decided to make an all new video with some new tactics, and I've already had this done, so I had to go on my secondary account, unlock the Locust, and start from scratch just to prove to you guys that this strategy actually works. So let's get into class setup. Class setup, sniper is whatever it is you happen to be working on. I got the Locust. I like the thermal sight, that's really good, the stock sight, but really you can use whatever you like, but obviously the thermal has the advantage of seeing through smoke. Enemy can throw out random smoke. Thermal is nice, but really use whatever you like. Attachments. Suppressor is nice, obviously, because you won't pop up on that minimap. I have noticed I do tend to get more hit markers, so you gotta aim high with it, but otherwise, suppressor is nice. Extended mag, stock can work if you wanna peek around corners, so suppressor, probably the most recommended out of that. Really important. Secondary, you need that to stay alive, and I'm going to be breaking down some clips for you guys, and you will see that having a secondary helps out a lot. You could risk picking up someone's random weapon, but I choose to go with the MR6, so that way I'm not surprised with getting someone's random weapon. Nice little option here is the shock charge. You know, when you're camping out, because yes, we're camping, I'm not a pro sniper, I'm just like you guys, I'm just an average sniper, okay? The shock charge is gonna be used sort of like a proximity alarm. We put that behind us, next to us, and that helps protect our back when we're camping. All right, next, we wanna make it as hard as possible to get killed, and so we're gonna need blind eye, don't wanna die from air support, flak jacket, don't wanna die by a random grenade, very important, cold-blooded. Cold-blooded has two purposes, immune from the ground streaks, and so that way you do not glow red on thermal sights. Last one, use whatever you like, but I do like tactical mask because it is not fun being stunned and trying to snipe, okay? It sucks, and so that's why I have tac mask. Specialists, one choice. If you have a problem staying alive, Nomad, rejack. Yes, you can rejack, and the streak continues, and yes, it will count, so we got to use rejack. It has saved my streak many times, and like I said, I'm going to be breaking down some clips for you guys. Score streaks, UAV, counter UAV, and Guardian. Guardian can be used sort of like another proximity alarm, and it can also be a distraction. Sometimes people, they want to shoot at it, and you can shoot them while they're shooting your Guardian. All right, so let's get into these clips. You know, a lot of people asked, so let's break them down. So here is clip one. I put down the little shock charge, and you know, that's to kind of just really let me know if someone's trying to flank me. And look at this, look at this horrible aim. But like I said, guys, I'm not a pro sniper. So if these tips can work for me, they can work for you. And you know, I'm just sitting here waiting, you know, I'm hanging back. You really don't want to be too aggressive with the sniper if you're not confident in your shot, okay? I'm not confident, no action's happening. Oh, but someone tripped up my little sensor there, my little proximity alarm. Where'd he get, where's he at? He's in here somewhere. And we see him, there's one kill. Now, instantly whip out my sidearm because I'm not sure if I'm gonna get a hit marker or not. But that sidearm, it's gonna come into play really, really big right here. I missed him, pulled the sidearm. Okay, great, that's my second kill. There's a nice spot right here. Now they're funneling on here. Nice place to get some snipes. Ooh, back to back. And so now I hit a bloodthirsty, but it's not a real one. I gotta get another sniper kill. Rejack saves the streak. Gotta get another sniper kill. A hit marker with that silenced sniper. Come on, just one more. There we go. As long as you get 5 kills in that life with that sniper, that counts. Okay, so let's move on to the next clip. Again, we're gonna put down a shock charge. I believe we did. Didn't we? No, not yet. But we got, there we go. Now we put down our shock charge because people are always flanking. That's what I do. And we're gonna hang back. Okay, we're being defensive. We're being part of the team. We're just protecting people. Nice little camping spot here. But ground tour safeguard is really good because, you know, people, there's a lot of targets and people huddle around the bot right there. Okay, but I did this in both ground war and regular safeguard. Both those modes can work. So this is just straightforward. You know, I already know people are shooting at the bot and they're gonna huddle around it. And then this is when the shock charge goes off and he's stunned. Boom, Bloodthirsty. That shock charge, it's already worked out for us. Final clip here, put down the shock charge. I do not believe it helps me out here, but we are playing more Safeguard. I like it because the spawns are controlled, not too many streaks. And boom, get that guy midair. This is a nice little camping spot here. I already know they're gonna spawn in there. Three down, all we need is two more. And I know they're gonna come out here. Oh Mike, what is this shot? Mikey, this is why you'll never be in phase. And another miss. But we got this nice little camping spot and bam. Oh, I think I got hit in the head. No, he didn't hit me in the head. But Rejack saves us. Come on, there we go. We just need one more. One more to get the camo. Oh, wait, what? What? And there we go. So there you go. See, Rejack helped me out there on that one. And so pretty much this class setup, we used everything. We used our sidearm. We used the shock charge. Rejack, obviously a big part of it. And that definitely helped me out. So hopefully after that, you guys can be done asking. All right, by the way, over the weekend, we had a $50 gift card giveaway on my Insta and on the Facebook. So the randomly chosen winners for that from Facebook, it's Daniel Gomez, and he picks the Amazon code. All right. And for Instagram, it was Alejandro is dead, and he picked the $50 PlayStation card. Okay. So the next contest will probably be on my Twitter when we hit 600K. So follow me on there for that. If you want updates on that, links to all my social stuff down below. All right. So what challenge or what topic do you guys want some suggestions with? Leave a comment below and I may get to work on that. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video. See you next time. So on the left side there, we have Black Ops 3 top 5 clips. This last one had a great ending. It was really worth it. Epic crossbow spree. This guy goes on and then the final thing that he does. It's awesome. A lot of people already saw it, but basically that's a playlist. You can click on the screen, links down below, epic top 5 clips, all kinds of different random weapons. And on the right side, Black Ops 3 tips, tricks, info, updates. That's another playlist. You can click on the screen or links down below.